That building sits just a few blocks away from City Hall, where workers caught those flames shooting through the roof of the Gaiety Building and smoke filling the streets of downtown Baltimore. We caught up with Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blake earlier, who spoke about the threat the strong winds posed to that fire.
We are glad that we have everyone's eyes on safety for our firefighters who are out here and making sure that we've sealed off this perimeter so that any curious onlookers aren't being endangered.
As you might imagine, the fire and fire equipment shut down many nearby streets, making the rush hour commute a nightmare for many who live and work in the city. We got dozens of pictures and videos from our viewers. Here's a look at the cell phone video of the fire taken earlier this afternoon and uploaded to WBALTV.com. And we've got a tremendous shot of the flames as they were ripping through the roof during the early part of that fire. This picture was sent into our website from U local member L. Brockman. Here's another shot of the fumes, huge plumes of smoke. You can see it rolling towards South Street and dozens of people who stopped to watch the action there. If you have any pictures or video of today's fire downtown, you can actually upload them to the U Local page on our website, WBALTV.com. Dozens of onlookers watched as crews worked to bring that fire under control. We caught up with some who worked in nearby buildings. Now, they described how it all unfolded. 11 News reporter Kai Reed joins us live from downtown now at the scene from their perspective. Kai?
Well, Rod, witnesses describe this scene as absolute chaos. Many of them watched on here as firefighters worked to get the fire under control.
Within 5-10 minutes, fires just started rolling up, but the smoke was just overwhelming.
Crowds of people gathered on the street to watch as firefighters frantically worked to put out the flames.
Pretty bad. Pretty bad. I hope ain't nobody got hurt.
Some were patrons of nearby businesses. Others had to be evacuated from their offices as smoke carried to adjacent buildings.
The smoke, and again, you could begin to feel it and smell it going through the hallways and into the various offices. The smoke actually started coming through our ventilation system, so it obviously reinforced the sense that we ought to get out of there.
Actually, I work a couple buildings over, saw the flames through the windows, and just started to come out and take a look.
Within minutes of the fire breaking out, witnesses sent pictures and videos to our website. This one's a street-level shot showing heavy smoke billowing down the street. Brittany Cooper and Jod Cadwell shot cell phone video just as firefighters got to the scene. They watched as employees and patrons ran for safety.
And there was just a bunch of girls running outside, getting dressed, everything like that. We saw all these people just evacuating the building.
They were pretty much naked as can be. Well, girls were running out with things jiggling, and they ran across the street to get dressed. Some of them were getting dressed right out front real fast. Some of them had their handful of clothes running across the street naked, trying to get over there to put their clothes on. It was chaos.
You can see the police tape up here behind me at Baltimore and Gay Street. Now, fire officials tell us that most of this block will be shut down for business tomorrow. Reporting live downtown, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.
We invite you to wake up with 11 News today at 5 a.m. for the latest on the fire. We'll tell you what roads are closed, how traffic is being affected, as well as the latest on the investigation. Again, that's 11 News today beginning at 5 a.m.